to see Miss Jean. She lives in a house that is mostly green, except for the chimney and windows and walls, and one or two places just down the halls. And swilled with rabbits and newts and snails, and fat little puppies that wag their tails, a whale and a tiger and elephants too.
Well, maybe not elephants.
Oh, Mary Dot, the mushrooms were sort of scarce today, weren't they?
Yes.
At least got one nice log full and a few other specimens. Hi. Let's go put Aurora on his perch and see what other specimens we have. Have a seat, Mark and Linda. Whoops.
He didn't get off.
Get up there, Aurora. Sometimes his toenails get stuck in my shawl. You want a berry? Here's something we were looking for. Recognize that, Linda and Mark?
Mm-hmm.
What would you call it?
Mushroom.
A mushroom, or what's a more scientific
fungi.
Word? A fungus. Two fungi. Good. Have a seat, Mary Dot.
Thank you.
Doesn't hurt to sit on a log with fungi on it. Well, let's see. Linda, what are fungi? Mushrooms are fun. All mushrooms are fungi, but not all fungi are mushrooms. That's something to think about. And this is my friend Mary Dot Jones, who thinks mushrooms are artistic. And she does some pretty things with them she's going to show us in a few minutes. But let's look at the real ones first before we look at the art ones. Have you ever looked at a mushroom and thought it would be a nice thing to do artwork with, Mark?
Yeah.
How about you? Have you ever looked at any mushrooms out in the woods and thought about going home and making some pottery mushrooms or some drawing mushrooms or some wooden mushrooms by sculpturing? Well, that's what we'd like to give you some ideas about today. And Mary Dot does painted mushrooms. Have you ever done any other kind? Didn't you do needlework once? Needlework ones once. Let's take a look at this log. Why is this log all covered with white fungi? And get this end down to the children.
There.
What are they doing there, Mark? They're growing?
Mm-hmm.
And are they doing any good in nature?
Yes.
What are they doing?
Well, they're sort of helping the log keep covered so a lot of things can't harm it.
Well, that's one part of it. And while they're growing, they're using the log for food, aren't they? See, they're not green like your jacket or like plants, other plants, so they can't make their own food. So they have to get their food from something that's dead, like dead wood. And when they take the food out of the log gets soft and crumbly. And in a year or two, it'll be turned into nice, rich dirt. Is it getting crumbly down at that end already?
Yes.
Do you know a special name for for fungi that stick out from the sides of trees or logs? What does that look like? You could put a book on it or a little toy or something.
A shelf!
Right. You've heard that, haven't you, Mary Dot?
Yes.
Shelf fungi. It'd have to be something very tiny to be on that one, but that's a little tiny shelf. And we have some bigger ones. Let's lay that down for a minute. But every time you look at a log covered with mushrooms, you can think the mushrooms are really doing a good job turning the log into dirt. Oh, here's something Mary Dot brought. Did you do this?
No, Mary Alice did that.
Mary Alice is Mary Dot's little girl, one of her little girls. You have another one named
Teresa,
and a little boy named
Christopher.
But Mary Alice likes to draw. And she did 10 different kinds of mushrooms for us to look at. Maybe she'll grow up to be a illustrator of mushroom books.
She'd like to illustrate, I think.
Here, Linda, you want to take a look at that? Maybe I'll give you some ideas.
There's some pretty colors.
There goes a turkey vulture sailing over the woods. Now, turkey vultures eat dead meat. That's their job in nature. And mushrooms live on dead plants. There are some mushrooms that live on dead insects.
Because one time we were in the neighborhood and I was playing, and then down there was a dead rabbit. And then the night before I wanted to see if it was still left, if it was still there, and it wasn't.
Well, and so a turkey vulture might have come by and taken it away, right? Let's look at that one you have, Mark. That's a pretty big one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Where do you think that came from?
A tree.
It's still got a piece of the bark hanging on to it. Now, see if I can help you figure out the name. See how shiny it is on top? Do you know the name of some shiny stuff that people put on furniture or...
Polish
you have to keep putting on, you know, every time you want to shine it up. But this is something you put on furniture when you first make it, or on floors to make them shiny and give
wax.
Them special. Well, the next thing to wax, varnish. Did you ever hear of varnish?
Yeah.
And this is called the varnished Ganoderma. Isn't that a name? The varnished Ganoderma. Ganoderma means something about it being sort of tough skinned. And varnish means it's shiny. And it grew on a tree like that. Sometimes you see them on old stumps, and they can be little or they can be big. And they're not good to eat. They're too tough. But they're good to collect and keep. And it's just sort of artistic the way it is.
It's swirly on the inside with curls right there.
Yes,
make a pretty background for an arrangement.
Yes, right. Put in some dried grasses like Linda has.
Nice.
What do you call these, Linda? They're fluffy and tickly, aren't they? A lot of people call these, you know what a lot of people call them that isn't right? A lot of people call them pampas grass.
That's what I was going to say.
But they can't be pampas grass because it's too cold here for pampas grass to grow all winter. And pampas grass is much bigger and fluffier. It gets to be taller than you are, and you're pretty tall.
Yeah.
So this is really miscanthus, and it comes from China. But it grows pretty well. We found this back behind Hodgepodge Lodge. You're going to take that to your friend, Marion? Good. Well, that would be something to do with a mushroom. Make a dried arrangement in it. Good. I knew you'd give us some good ideas.
We've got one more here.
And that one? That came off.
Broke off.
Yeah. That's a lower one, but it's also very tough.
It feels like wood.
All right, and it wouldn't be good to eat. This is the...
Like slots,
right. And there's a really nice story about those slots. I don't know whether I ever told it to you. I've told it to some of my friends about the man. Did you ever hear about the man who made his son some wings out of seagull feathers and put them together with wax?
Yeah.
And that boy's name was Icarus, and the man's name was Daedalus. And the boy flew too close to the sun, and all the wax melted, and his feathers fell off, and he fell into the sea and drowned. That's sort of a sad story, but do you think it's a true story?
No.
It's a myth. But anyway, that man was supposed to have designed a big building called the Labyrinth. Did you
yep.
remember that? What did he keep in there? What was kept in this big building? A fierce bull called a Minotaur. And to keep the Minotaur happy, they had to feed him some maidens every year, some young girls. This is not a true story either, just a make-believe story. But anyway, there was a hero named Theseus who went to kill the bull so no more maidens would get eaten. And this was what the building was like. It had all these little slots in it, like a maze, right, Mark? So he didn't want to get lost while he was hunting for the bull. So he took a spool of thread, and wherever he tied it at the outside, and then wherever he went, he unwound the thread, and he found the bull and killed him, and then he got safely back out of the labyrinth. But this mushroom is called Daedalus, or called Daedalia, after Daedalus, who built the labyrinth. Isn't that a good story to remember? Would you like to take that one with you, Mark, so you can remember, tell that story to some of your friends?
I read another story that it had something like this grandfather, there's a sorcerer that told him that his grandson would cause his own death. And then his grandfather... There was this other girl that was put under a spell or something. If they looked at her face, then they'd turn into something like...
Mushrooms?
No. like a statue.
Yeah. Oh.
You know, and then so he had to go in and cut off her head.
Wow, goodness. Well, that's...
And anyway, see, there's this other dragon or something that comes out of the sea, and it eats a maiden every month, one of the king's daughters, and so he went down and he put the face up in front of it, and it turned into stone.
Well, it's fun to read stories like that, as long as you don't believe they're real,
yeah.
And just use your imagination. Let's look behind us where Aurora's sitting. Do you see any fungi or mushrooms on that?
Yes.
That is a wall hanging that was given to me by my friends Kim and Sue. And they used all kinds of imagination in that, imaginary different kinds of flowers and mushrooms. And it's just cheerful. I keep it on the wall at the end of my bed, and every time I wake up in the morning and open my eyes, it wakes me up really fast because of the bright colors. And those are mushrooms made out of felt. Let's see what you'd brought in that shot.
Here's a similar thing, the painted.
Oh, that's cheerful. My goodness. Now, how'd you get this idea? Tell us the whole story.
The whole family was painting hex signs, the Pennsylvania Dutch signs. And I wanted to do something different with my circle. So I like the flowers and the bright colors.
Mushrooms. And sometimes you would look at a real mushroom to get your inspiration, but this time, I think
this was just fantasy.
This was imaginary mushroom. It looks like a boletus to me, because it has little pores underneath instead of gills.
Right. I like mushrooms. Most people don't appreciate how pretty they are, so I put it in with all the flowers.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad you said that, because I have known a lot of people and children, too, that just go by and step on every mushroom they come to.
They're fun to squash once in a while.
But they're really doing their job in nature, and some of them even make good meals if you're very careful and you know which ones are good to eat.
Friend of ours, I was going up to their house, and then they had a couple of mushrooms along, and then we were playing a game, and then we were running along, and they came across, and like they hit a mushroom with their thing, and went flying right up in the air.
My goodness. There's one kind of mushroom that it is fun to step on after it's dry. Did you ever find one of those that are like round balls?
Yes.
Have you ever found one of those?
Yeah. You know what they're called?
You squeeze them with your finger or with your foot, and big clouds of spores come out.
Oh, I've seen one of them, I forget, just a few days ago.
And they're called puff balls. And they're good to eat when they're fresh, but they're fun to make the spores come out.
See, we went over to somebody's house, and we went on a walk in the woods, and on this log or something.
Oh, yes. Wasn't I on that walk? Mm-hmm. That was at Claire's house. Right. That was good. I'd forgotten about that, Linda. Mark, I know you're especially interested in insects, aren't you? And sometimes you go out to look for mushrooms and other fungi. You may not find very many of those, but you might turn over a log and find some big, black...
Beetles?
Beetles, right. You look at one of these, and I'll look at one and see what you can tell me about this, because I think you're pretty good on entomology. Gosh, I've got four of them in here, and one of them's biting the other one's toe.
Yeah.
They won't let go.
Yes, well...
Two.
Well, there's one for Mark. All right, and you tell me what you can tell me. One time you told me that you knew an insect was an insect because of the parts of his body. Can you remember the names of those?
Head, thorax, and abdomen.
Right, the head, thorax, and abdomen. Did you know that, Linda?
Squeaks.
He squeaks, and that's how these beetles get their name.
Hair's in the way.
Can you hear him squeaking?
Yes.
Linda, you want to hear him squeaking?
I sure hear back, too.
In some books, if you look these up, you'll hear them called Bessie bugs.
I heard that.
They're really beetles, and these are really beautiful, shiny beetles. And they look very fierce because they have sort of pinchers out front, and they're waving their antennae around. But when we turned over a log when we were looking for fungi, and we found these four beetles here. I think they were going to hibernate for the winter. Whoops. I think I'll put one of them in my terrarium because it's fun to hear that noise. It really doesn't sound like he's saying Bessie to me, but it sounds like he's very upset at somebody taking him out of his happy home. So we'll have to make another happy home for him.
He's crawling off. Okay.
Do you know how you can always tell a beetle? He has hard wings that meet in a straight line down the back. Look at the one Mark has, Linda, and you can see it better. Oh, Mark made a nice home for his on the fungus.
See, you can hardly see the space between the wings.
That's a funny little noise.
It's real loud now.
A Bessie bug.
It's like a little split.
Really should say Bessie beetle. Right, Aurora?
Probably where it takes off the skin.
Hi, Aurora. We still love you, even though we're looking at the beetles. Well, let's see what some other people. I know you have one more thing, Mary Dopp, but let me show you some of my mushroom art collection. My friends Nancy and George sent me this, and I couldn't believe it, because they wrote a letter and said, we hope you like the plate, and when you look at the mushrooms, be sure you notice that they're all made with thumbprints.
How interesting.
Mushrooms made That's with great. Thumbprints. I'll pass it along so you all can get a look at it. But that's something we all like to mess around with, finger paints. But to be able to make all different kinds of mushrooms with that. Thumbprints.
See
the
prints? Yeah, you can see tell by these touch. Little lines. See that from there.
Makes them look real too, doesn't it?
Nancy and George sent me another piece of mushroom art too. Here's one for you all to look at. It's the same sort of thing. Linda, what do you call a person that draws pictures?
Artist?
An artist. That's the name of this fungus, the artist fungus. Because when you find one of these, when it's just fresh on a tree, here's a great huge one. That's how it looks when it's growing on the tree. And you turn it over, it'll be nice and white. Now this one I've had for a while, so it sort of turned yellow, and one of my friends scribbled on it. But you get it when it's nice and white, and take something sharp. You can draw any kind of a picture on it that you want. And this friend of Nancy's and George's did a blue jay feeding his babies in the nest on a pine tree. So that's a very nice artist fungus. And that's a big artist
it's
fungus. And Linda, were you on this trip?
Which one?
Your sister's name is on there.
I know.
Yep, there's your sister's name. That's from a trip that I went on with a lot of my friends. And Linda's sister, Mary Ann, was in our car. And she signed her name.
You remember? Know, we went to
Carry Run.
Yeah, I went on that one. Except, like, I had to leave early.
Right. Let's look at your other work of art.
This is very, very real mushrooms.
There's an airplane. I bet he's up so high he can't see any mushrooms, even if they were great big ones. But maybe they might be having mushrooms for lunch or supper on that plane. This is beautiful. Now, where did you these look real.
I tried to make them look real.
Now, did you go out and get real specimens, or did you?
Some of them, the ones that I could find. But then I found some other more colorful ones in books.
I recognize this one. That's the morel that we all love to go out and look for in the springtime that tastes so delicious, if you can find it.
I started off just putting edible ones, but I couldn't find enough pretty edible ones, so there are some very deadly ones on here, too.
And this one I recognize as the pine cone mushroom, because it has little little scales all over the top like pine cones. And, see, is that an inky cap way over there?
I think so,
An inky cap.
This one, I think, isn't that an edible? Doesn't it look like?
Yes, it does.
I've forgotten the name.
I don't eat very many different kinds. It's better to know a few that are safe.
Right.
This is the one that makes you upchuck, this one with a red top.
I think this one, the blue one, was very poisonous, too.
Oh, that's beautiful, though.
It's pretty, yes.
Oh, this is too pretty to use.
I haven't yet. Just hang it up like a picture.
Did you draw them on first?
I drew them on very, very thin paper, tracing paper, and colored them, and then cut each one out and glued them on the tray.
Oh, for heaven's
sakes.
Oh, decoupage. Do you know that word, children?
Well, that's how you hook paper pictures onto things. You glue them on and then put varnish over them.
Maybe so. Yeah, that. How did you know that, Mark? How did you know there's some mushrooms that make you have interesting dreams? I hope. There's some people in Mexico and over in parts of Russia that eat special mushrooms just because it makes them have wild dreams. But I don't think that sounds like a very good thing to you to do, do you? No, but that might be what happened to that man. I think he's sitting in an apple tree, though, not a cliff.
Mushrooms go with my favorite.
I can see the outlines right there.
Yes. Mushrooms go with your favorite?
My outline to my black.
Yep.
Decoupage, that's where you cut something out of paper and paste it on.
That one looks sort of like a Chinese hand.
Uh-huh, it does.
Well, what do you think this mushroom's made out of?
Here.
Now, why don't you, let's pop it down there so we might want to take another look at that. We'll put it in front of Mary, of Linda.
Okay.
There
you go.
Can you tell from here what this mushroom's made out of?
Clay.
Right. And when you feel it, it feels sort of sandy, and that shows the clay wasn't really very fancy clay. I got this when I was on a trip to West Virginia at a little pottery shop where they just made things out of the clay they could get in their backyard. And there is a mushroom that is lavender like this. I think the color is so pretty.
I think it's on there.
Lavender. Yeah, that might be the very same
one. I think it is.
All right. Take a look at this one, children, and see what you think about that.
What is that made out of?
Feels real. Or plastic.
What do you think? Is it real?
It feels like one of those dog, toy bones.
Yes, that's right. But it's made out of plastic or rubber, but it's so real it would almost fool you, wouldn't you? Mm. Wouldn't you think? I know some friends who buried one in a lady's driveway one time. She got so excited because she thought she was getting fresh mushrooms in the middle of winter. They were coming up in her driveway. But I have a friend, Connie, who's, I think, going to be an artist. Mm-hmm. And she made me a little paperweight with a mushroom on out of a flat stone. Have you ever tried that?
Yeah. See, my father has one with the lion on it.
Oh, does he?
Yeah,
oh.
His friend made it.
Well, maybe you'd like to look at that one that Connie made me. Let's see, what other things could you make mushrooms out of?
Oh, look at that one.
Can you tell from what this made out of, Mark?
Glass.
Glass, right. And so it would be breakable, so we have to take good care of this one. It's not as tough as the one you have the Bessie Beetle on.
I know, because my parents, when they went to Italy, they had a big glass man. And it was so full of glass, it looks like you can't even break it.
But it will break, won't it?
Yeah.
Here are a lot of good things come from West Virginia, and this is one, a mushroom made out of
wood.
And it almost looks like a real one. And
it kind of looks like wood because it's not really exactly smooth.
Right, I know, you can see where the knife made the chips, but I still think it's pretty. And the lady at the shop that was selling these had a whole row of them on a log, and they really looked as if they just popped up there. So a glass mushroom, a wooden mushroom.
One time, I was going along, and I was walking on someone's yard. I saw a mushroom about this high.
Good heavens. I just got somebody sent me a picture out of the paper of two little kids in Australia that were hiding under a mushroom. Can you imagine a mushroom big enough to hide under?
We had a book in, we had an order in school to order a book, and they had a book called all about hiding under a mushroom.
Oh, well, that would be a nice...
I think my girls have that book.
A nice secret place to hide.
You'd hold them for
Here are some little metal mushrooms. They're very heavy and good for paperweight. I don't know what the metal would be. Bronze, I guess. Oh, goodness, there go two turkey vultures. I hope they don't think we're dead because we've been sitting still so long.
We better jump around.
They're looking for something dead.
They look pretty and graceful up there.
Don't they, though? Be a nice day to be out flying.
They're sort of ragged looking when they get up close.
Our friends have a hawk. Our friends have pit hawks.
Oh, he likes to eat. He eats meat, too.
Yeah, right. And we took him out. And we had to, hit some bushes with sticks to get rabbits.
Oh, so he could catch his own rabbits, good.
Last year, we went on a field trip, and we went somewhere, and they had, a stuffed king vulture.
Oh, they come from Africa, I think. Here's a marble mushroom. And my friend Heather made a little elf to sit on top of it. Because don't you sometimes see pictures of elves sitting on mushrooms?
He's made out of Play-Doh.
He's made out of clay. And sometimes you see a toad sitting on a mushroom, a picture of a toad. Some people call them toadstools, and they think they're places for toads to sit.
Chip.
And even in Alice in Wonderland, there's a mushroom. A caterpillar sitting on a mushroom. So you see mushrooms lots of places. Yes, unfortunately, that fell off the mantle and got chipped. And then nowadays, you're seeing lots of candles with mushrooms. Too pretty to burn. And I even got a letter the other day from a boy up in Mexico, New York. His name is Adrian Richardson, and he had beautiful stationery with mushrooms inside the envelope. So I think it's fun to look around and see how many different places you can see people using mushrooms in art. And are you going to do any more artwork with mushrooms, Mary Dot?
Yes, I'm going to do some crewel embroidery on a skirt.
Oh.
And mushroom design down the front of it.
Oh, great. Well, maybe you can come back and show us that when you get through.
Okay.
Do you have anything at home with mushrooms on it, Linda?
I don't think so.
How are you getting along with your Bessie beetle, Mark?
Starting to pinch.
He's crawling on you. Yeah, look, he is. He's pinching his finger.
Yeah. Well, maybe you'll be an entomologist, Mark. Do you think you might be an entomologist when you grow up? If you already know about the head, thorax, and abdomen, you'll probably learn lots more. Don't let him get lost. Pass him back if you don't want to hold on to him. I hope you've had a good time today finding out about mushrooms in art. Thank you very much, Mary Dot,
coming
and bringing your two beautiful masterpieces here. And I hope you will share anything else that you do with mushrooms in it with us. Look around and see what ideas you can get about using mushrooms in any kind of art. Try carving a mushroom in wood, or making a candle that's shaped like a mushroom, or drawing a mushroom, or making one out of clay, or painting one on a rock. And if you can find an artist fungus, then you can really do a whole scene on a mushroom. Goodbye, and come back soon again to Hodgepodge Lodge.
Was made possible through funds contributed by members of the Maryland Center for Public Broadcasting.
In the studios of the Maryland Center for Public Broadcasting.